Hello everyone, and welcome back to part 2 of this tutorial where we are creating a Dragon Ball Z style character using the headshot plugin from Reallusion. So let's start with the eyes. Whenever we create a character using the headshot plugin, there are some layers which are created by default. So in this case, it's the eye occlusion and the tear line. Because we have a cartoon character, we don't need these two layers, so we can go ahead and select it from the scene panel and delete it. Because this is a cartoon character, we don't need these eyelashes, so let's go to the modify panel, go to the texture tab and select the eyelashes, reduce the opacity to 0. Let's replace the teeth of this character. We'll hide all the other parts from the scene menu and go to the content tab over here and go to the teeth, and let's use this game style teeth for this character. We will place the teeth later on. We'll also replace the eyes for now, and I'll hide the rest of the body. We'll go to the eyes panel over here and select the slacker eyes, and we'll replace only the material. Before we position the eyes and teeth properly, let's fix the eye socket. So I'll just select the model, go to edit mesh and select face tab over here. What I'll do is I'll select one of the faces from the socket inside and then use the grow option over here in the faces to select the number of faces that I want to hide. So this looks good. We can go ahead and click on hide option over here. We can repeat this process again for the other eye as well. And now I want to increase the scale of the iris. So select the eyes, go to the sliders in the modify panel. In CC base eye, I can increase the iris scale. And now let's go to the eye sliders and search for eyeball. And let's reduce the scale of the eyes and increase the height. Let's decrease the width of the eyeballs so the eyes are closer to the nose, and also increase the depth. Because this is a cartoon character, I want the texture of this character to be more flat. So let's open the texture of the head in Photoshop. Just select one of the colors from the skin and paint over on the eyes and the mouth to make the colors look more flat. And we'll repeat this for the rest of the textures. We'll fix the hair texture which is coming on the forehead. This looks good. Let's save the texture. We can see that there is still some hair visible on the forehead. That is because of the bump map. We'll open the bump map texture on Photoshop and fix that. That looks much better. And now we can work on the mouth of the character. So let's give an exaggerated expression. This looks good to work on. And now we'll go to edit mesh option and use the smooth brush to relax some of the faces on the character. We can notice some deformation on the lips, so we'll relax some of the faces in this area as well. And now we can place the teeth that we have created for this character. So we need to make sure the upper portion of the teeth is placed properly and then the lower. So to select them separately, we'll go to the select faces option, select one of the faces on the top and then click on grow multiple times. So the upper portion of the teeth is selected, and we'll move this to the top, and similarly we'll repeat the same process for the lower portion of the teeth. And now we'll give a normal smile expression to the character. Let's fix the eyes over here. And now we can fix the mouth. Even with a normal expression, we can see that the mouth is open. So we'll go to the lip options over here. And let's go to the lip seam sliders. And scroll down to the last second slider, which is lip close open. And we'll decrease this to close the mouth of the character. This looks good. Now let's add the hair for this character. I've already separated the hair model from the character using Blender. And now I can simply drag and drop the 3D hair into the scene and place it according to the CC character. This looks good. And let's try to match the character with the head. And because this is a Dragon Ball Z character, I think we can keep a bulky body. So we can increase these two sliders over here. This looks good. Let's add a talking animation to the character and see if the expressions are looking good. After completing this, I realized that there is some kind of deformations on the character. This is because of the bump map which is applied on the head. So we'll go ahead and delete the bump map to have a flat texture, and this looks better. And that's how you can create a Dragon Ball Z style character using the headshot plugin by Reallusion. I hope you like this tutorial. Please like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more updates. Thanks for watching.